Should Halloween be canceled at all these schools in and around Chicagoland? Our boss, Kenny, is hanging out with us this morning. In for Katie. You live in Glen Ellen.
You're filling in, Kenny.
You are, Kenny. You didn't know that, but as of about 8 seconds ago, you're filling in for Katie. Dave already canceled Halloween and all the festivities at your kids' school, correct?
Yeah, it is now known as a harvest party.
A harvest party. Does that bother you at all, you and your wife?
You know what? If they canceled it in the city or the town or the village altogether, yes. In the school, I completely understand. I completely understand it. Just like peanuts, you just roll with it.
Okay.
Just like
all right.
Peanuts.
Are you saying because of like nut allergies and stuff like that, you can't please everybody and you don't want to exclude anybody?
Yeah. You know what? If you have fifth graders with masks on going around scaring the kindergartners, you know, I think that could be a problem.
Yeah. Okay. But, and you know, and I think some of these cancellations, it's because of, you know, religious purposes and other things. But when I celebrated Halloween, let's just, for this, the sake of this conversation, let's completely take religion out of this thing. Because I've never known anybody to celebrate Halloween for religious purposes whatsoever. We dressed up, we passed out candy, we got candy, we went out, we had shaving cream fights, we rolled people's houses, we rolled our own house. We just had a blast. I love dressing up in costume. This is my most favorite time of the year. So this bothers me because as a kid, we were allowed to do this. And all of a sudden, it seems like in the last few years that people are you know, they're sensitive because people are celebrating Halloween at school and at elementary school.
Yeah, I think it's less about celebrating it for religion, but people that don't celebrate it because of their religion is also. But to me, it's a weird thing about inclusion, right? So inclusion ultimately means that you universally add things. So if people aren't going to, especially kids, I think it's really important. I'm Jewish. I grew up in schools that went ahead and celebrated Christmas. They had Christmas trees. There's still Santa, all of that stuff.
And you didn't feel excluded, did you?
No, because I know about it. So I was included because I have the information. And if you're going to do that, if you're going to try and include all these kids, then you should actually then teach the rest of the kids about the other tradition. So me, like, that's an opportunity to go ahead and teach more about inclusion by adding as opposed to taking away for those traditions. So now those kids will also know about their classmates' traditions and their religion. And it doesn't mean you're pushing religion on anybody, but you're also recognizing that people are different and that's okay. And everyone has different customs and come from a different place. And I don't know if it's a missed opportunity. It's a really hard place to navigate as a teacher these days. And I'll give them this, that you guys have to make hard decisions every single day. That's just the other side that I would say that you have an opportunity to teach everything now.
So, well, of course. And not only is it happening in Glen Ellen, Kenny, where you and your wife and your kids live, but it's also happening in Evanston. And we're talking about this elementary school. It's Lincoln Elementary School. And the parents evidently are up in arms, but it was in the school book that they give you at the beginning of the school year, which of course the parents never read all of those lines.
Yeah,
so the parents are saying, look, you didn't give us a heads up on any of this. And we're really upset about it. But the school district saying, as part of our school and district-wide commitment to equity, we are focused on building community and creating an inclusive, welcoming environments for all. Should they cancel Halloween at elementary schools these days? Madison, you're on the south side. What are your thoughts on this?
So I believe that, like, we should not be canceling Halloween. It's a time for creativity and fun for a lot of kids. I know it's my favorite holiday as a special effects artist, but my big thing is when I was in elementary school, actually, I went to school with Aaron. We used to learn about Dia de los Muertes, which is, of course, the Mexican Day of the Dead. And being half Mexican, that was really interesting to learn about things that I did not know about my own culture.
Your own heritage, right? Yeah.
I thought it was really interesting. That's an opportunity to include everybody by teaching. Those are teaching moments.
Of course. And
right?
The people that don't celebrate Halloween, then they teach you about their culture and why they don't celebrate Halloween. So, now you're kind of excluding everybody.
Yeah, I do think it's the opposite. When you do inclusion, it should be universally adding things and not taking things away.
Correct. And whatever you do in life, it doesn't matter what you do, even personally, professionally, whatever, you're not going to be able to please everybody 100% of the time. That's why I think this is totally ridiculous. CJ, you're on in Naperville. You're on with Jason and Katie, Aaron and Scotty. Good morning.
Good morning. Love you guys.
We love you too. Thank you, CJ.
Jason, I'm with you. Halloween is one of my favorite holidays. But the reality of the matter is, like Scotty said, it's supposed to be additive. If it's inclusive, it's additive. Mm-hmm. And I think it's hypocritical for them to take away Halloween if you're not going to take other holidays away that my child doesn't celebrate then.
Yeah, I agree. And I'll tell you what, teachers have hard decisions to make every day, and administrators in schools, it is a hard climate. I'm not taking anything away from them. It is a hard climate to navigate those routes, but I do think it's conversations that need to happen.
Yeah, for sure.
And
I love
think it's unfortunate.
And CJ, I loved how you said you agreed with Scotty, and Scotty goes, after you made your statement, Scotty goes, I agree.
Yeah, I agree with you agreeing with me.
Can you be the parent? Hard to explain to my child,
yeah, right,
when they ask me why, when I don't even agree with it.
Of course not. Becca, you're a teacher. Good morning. You're on with Jason and Katie on US 99.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, so I'm a teacher. I teach in a low-income school district.
Mm.
So I understand the part of wanting to celebrate it, but seeing these students grow up and not have the money to
great
buy
point. Classes,
okay, that is a really very good point. Never even thought about that.
So great point.
I completely agree with teaching about how it's celebrated in different cultures and all of that, but not necessarily bringing those costumes to school,
right,
so they can still celebrate it at home,
yeah,
but it's really hard to see kids who have the full-on $50, $60 costume from a costume store, mm-hmm, and then someone who put on like a t-shirt or
yeah,
something.
That's
so
true, too. Yeah.
That.
Give your school a shout out right now. Where do you teach?
I teach in the East Aurora School District.
Awesome. Oh, my mom used to make our costumes going. I remember I went to first grade with our big paper mache Bart Simpson head.
Mine did, too. Mine did, too. Thank you so much for the calls. We really appreciate it. 756 on US 99. You're listening to Jason and Katie.